any struggles I faced during the making of this album? Actually, because I used to be an independent singer-songwriter, and then I used to release material on my own. The difference is that right now I'm signed to a really fantastic label that I really love working with, and my mentors, Lisa Song and Li Wei Song, they are very, very experienced and they have pretty high standards. So when I made this album, the struggle was more of trying to learn what they want from me as a singer, as a musician, and as a songwriter as well. So, I mean, it was a really, really good learning experience that I treasure a lot as well. So the biggest struggle, I think, would probably be just being real while I was singing in studio. Yeah, you know, when just singing sincerely, yeah, bringing the real feelings into the song. Yeah. Actually, when I was in primary school, which is a pretty long time ago, no, I'm just kidding, but I used to speak Chinese at home, and then after that, because I went to a convent school in secondary school, so then I started speaking more and more English and listened to more English songs, you know. So I guess I'm pretty much bilingual, which I hope Singaporeans are. So I mean, I try as much as I can to be bilingual. Yeah, I've always listened to Chinese songs as well outside of English songs. The thing is, Chinese songs have more ballads and things like that. So it wasn't really a conscious decision to make a switch to do Chinese music. To me, music is still a universal language. So as long as we have good melodies, we have great singers, we make good music, hopefully that still connects with people regardless of what language it's in. When I saw Stephanie Sun, I was very, very surprised. Yeah, but it was really great seeing her as well, because I guess she is kind of, in a way we call xuejie in Chinese, which means, you know, she's my senior. And I actually really like her music as well, and I like her albums. You know, she has a fantastic personality. She's very easygoing, down to earth. So I feel very, very lucky that she actually listened to my album, and yeah, she liked some of the songs. So yeah, I would really want to thank her as well. I mean, I've said that so many times to her already. I bet she's sick of it. So to me, we are both different human beings and different musicians and singers. So as I said earlier, I really like her music as well. And I mean, I think she has a fantastic voice. So if people want to make comparisons, I can't really control that. The only thing I can focus on is just to make my music the way I want to, and try to be good at what I do, and that's it. Yeah. 5 years time. 5 years is a long time to me. Actually, a lot of things cannot really be planned. So what I do is I just kind of live every day. I know it sounds really cliche, but I try to live every day to its fullest. I have a goal for each day, and then I go after that goal and I try to nail it down for that day. So hopefully that's what I do for the next 5 years. This in this particular venue that we're doing the album launch actually has a lot of meaning to me, because I used to sing here every week, and then I left for a while to make this album, and then actually the label asked me, so we're going to do an album launch in Singapore. Do you have any suggestions? Where do you want to do it? I said, let's go to Hood Bar. Because to me, I like this place, and I'm very comfortable here. And I think that as a performance, it's important to just be comfortable on stage, and then just to focus on the music itself and just deliver the performance. So launching the album in a bar again, to me, it's a good thing. Where did you hear that?
My sauces.
Ooh. Oh no, your sauces have to be checked. Really?
Is it not true?
Oh well, right now I'm actually single, so I don't have a you know, I'm single right now. But the thing is, with relationships, it's just, you can never tell when the next one's coming, or, you know. So, I guess I'm still looking for true love, I guess, as cheesy as it sounds.